right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Glen Parsons. He's the CEO of Awalé Resources. And Glen, it's good to see you. How are you?
Thanks, Steve. No, very well, thank you.
Yeah, excited to learn a bit more about the company and what you're up to. Tell me a bit about Awalé Resources.
Yeah, so I mean, Awalé's been around a while. We started as a greenfield explorer. I mean, effectively, we took these properties. You know, we sold the original Mariana Resources, the whole company, to Sandstorm because they were looking after. They really wanted the Hod Maden asset in Turkey, but fundamentally, you know, Mariana was a multi-jurisdictional explorer. And Sandstorm didn't want the exploration assets. They're a royalty company, and I took the Côte d'Ivoire assets. You know, I can speak French, which is obviously advantageous, but fundamentally, you know, we were in an underexplored region, you know, gold focused, and really was time to sort of give it a life of its own. So post Mariana, that's what we did.
Okay, and you've got the Odienne Project, which has some news out on it, because I know you did an initial drill program there. So tell me a bit about the project itself, and then sort of the drill program that you just finished off.
Yeah, so I mean, we really had two project areas, one in the east of Côte d'Ivoire, one in the west, in the northwest, and that's Odienne. And really, you know, we started as really early greenfields exploration, and we just carried on doing systematic exploration. And slowly, we really started seeing something starting to develop at Odienne. I mean, we had some early stage luck in terms of right at the bottom, sort of orogenic shear zone hosted gold mineralization, which really formed quite a nice body. A little bit contained, but structurally, you know, there was offsetting and things. So we sort of started really trying to find satellite deposits, and then we found one nice satellite anomaly, we drilled it, and it wasn't actually sort of typical from the previous discovery. It actually was something totally different, and that's really what spawned the whole Odienne, I suppose, excitement, if you want to call it from our side. In the sense that it's actually the mineralization style is really what we would call iron oxide copper gold, which hasn't been seen before in Côte d'Ivoire. And what really is exciting and the potential of these systems is that around the world, they're major contributors in terms of copper and gold. They are significant scale systems at the end of the day. So this is a little bit, you know, I suppose it's not left field in terms of West Africa, but in terms of Côte d'Ivoire, first type of alteration style seen like this. So we are very excited about that. And it's based on this that we actually got, you know, Newmont was pretty excited to start considering a joint venture with us. And we sort of worked together going through due diligence and certainly ticked all the boxes from their side. And now we're sitting with this joint venture, which really started in June last year in 2022, and has led up to a greater understanding of the system. And then, as you say, in December we got to the stage where two of our targets, and we have multiple targets over this 400 square kilometers of granted license, and we've got this magmatic fluid mineralization anomalism happening all over the whole license with multiple targets. But our two most definable drill ready targets were Charger and what we call Sceptre East, and they are copper gold anomalies. We drilled those in December, and we're sort of chasing these bigger sulfide accumulation bodies. And that's sort of typical of these RSEG systems. And, you know, from the results that we've seen visually, we are hitting these sulfides, which is pretty exciting. There is a pyrite, chalcopyrite, a molybdenum association, plus the other pathfinders. So we certainly have copper to a degree, you know, from an XRF perspective, but we really are looking to wait for these results to really give us, you know, what have we encountered and what are we going to expect.
Yeah, and as I mentioned, you're waiting for those assays to come back. So are you going to wait till you get these results back before you decide the next step? Or are you looking at following up on Charger, Main, Sceptre East that you talked about, obviously? And you also, I understand, want to do some ground physics as well. So there seems to be a lot of work ahead of you. Are you waiting or getting started right away?
Yeah, so we are actually moving forward. I mean, there's no doubt we're moving forward. From the next stage of drilling, I mean, we did 1,200 meters in November, December, and that's just because that's what the budget allowed from the JV perspective. It's such a big system, and we've drilled into these bodies. It really makes sense, you know, in terms of the next phase, to wait for those results to give you a better understanding of how we push forward. As I say, we could probably go straight back now and do extension drilling, do broader drilling around what we've done. But then we've got the target right up in the north, 18 kilometers to the north, which is actually, you know, it's in a sense, it's exactly like Charger, but probably, you know, 2-3 times bigger than Charger already. And Sceptre is 20 times bigger than Charger. So you've got these big areas. So the only way, I think, at this stage, I mean, we've been really systematic about our approach. Newmont does like our systematic approach. And it makes sense, you know, from a budget perspective to just keep on building this. But we're pretty excited. We are going back into the drilling in this next quarter. So that's pretty key.
All right. Sounds like it's going to be a lot of news flow coming out with the results and also when the drilling starts again. So, Glen, thanks very much. Good to catch up with you and see what's going on, and really appreciate your time.
Thanks, Steve. Thanks very much.
All right, there's Glen Parsons, the CEO of Awalé Resources.